is full of cities. Richard Saul Wurman said, we're going to have mega cities, big ones, 20 million more, all over the world dotted. And we're going to have to make them smarter. We're going to have to make them more livable. We're going to have to deal with all the issues that cities have about creating places that are happy and smart and efficient. So we are equally honored this morning to, or this afternoon, to have Her Excellency Dr. Yasha present about what they're doing in the city of Dubai. And this is a bold effort to create the future using also GIS. So without further ado, I'm going to ask that Dr. Yasha come, Her Excellency, who runs the Smart Dubai program. She doesn't exactly run Dubai, but maybe you might say, okay, kind of close.
Thank you. Thank you, Jack.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Dr. Yasha. My great pleasure to have you.
Thank you. Actually, this is one of the hardest tasks I've ever been taking in my life. Presenting in front of 16,000 plus, and after a magical show like the Disney show. So ladies and gentlemen, allow me to share with you our story in making Dubai the happiest city on earth. By implementing smart tools such as GIS data and platforms. I just want to challenge you that this technology isn't only transforming our cities, it's transforming also our lives. It's making us much closer to our families, our friends, and our people, making us more happier. For Smart Dubai, technology is only a mean to an end. Our end goal is people happiness. And we are creating happiness for our people by using technologies as tools. Enabled by new technologies, we are making our city experiences much efficient, seamless, safe, and impactful for everyone in Dubai. And we are fortunate to be guided by His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, the Prime Minister of United Arab Emirates and the ruler of Dubai, who has challenged the role of the government and championed our collective ambition towards making citizens happier. Yes, in UAE and in Dubai, the role of the government is to serve happiness. And we are inspired by his wisdom, and we are pursuing our smart city vision to make Dubai the happiest city on earth. And we didn't begin our story just recently. This story started 2 decades ago. Over many years, we have witnessed the transformation efforts of our colleagues across the Dubai government, who have dedicated themselves to applying advanced technology to improve experiences in the city. And it's not only by the public sector entities, but also by the private sector entities, such as Emirates Airlines, by building world-class repetitions through technology. And so when the Smart Dubai Initiative was announced in 2014, we knew that we would be able to benefit from the experience and commitment of our partners, both in government and private sector. Our challenge, therefore, has not been to build a smart city transformation from scratch, just like Zootopia, but rather to unify the existing efforts that are already underway in our public and private sectors. And many of the city managers can understand me that the issue was to remove all these silos between entities, whether it be government or private. And to do this, we have focused our approach on delivering the best ICT infrastructure and regulatory environment, keeping data at the heart of our city transformation. As the data and insights arm of Smart Dubai, the Dubai Data Establishment has been just as dedicated to create impact for the city through data. Dubai Data is the most ambitious data initiative we've seen globally, and it is fueling our smart city transformation, keeping privacy and security at the heart of that initiative. The impact of Dubai data spans the whole city, combining the impact of data across every sector in Dubai. And we found out that by 2021, opening private and public sector data will result in a gross value added impact of $2.9 billion in every year. That's more, almost extra $1,000 added per person in Dubai every year. That study not only revealed how the city will benefit from open and shared data, it has also helped us in identifying and prioritizing which data sets have the potential to create added value to the city. Whether it is from geospatial data sets like location-based services for transportation maps and wayfinding, but also even sectors like art. And as they say, everything happens somewhere, and this is never more true than when running a city. This is why we have signed a citywide ELA with Esri to provide the full suite of ArcGIS platform capabilities, not only for the government, but also for the private sector through the Dubai Pulse as the city cloud platform. And when we have already begun to fuel the benefits of data in Dubai, this spring we published the city's first open data sets on Dubai Pulse, the public's portal to the digital heart of Dubai. These open data sets, prepared with the support of over 100 data champions from 24 government entities, are opening the city's most valuable data for the first time to entrepreneurs, data scientists, statisticians, and other innovators. Armed with the insight from this data, we are ready as a city to lead the transformation changes that will define the future of Dubai. So let me introduce my colleagues, Kavi Visali, advisor to the Dubai Data Establishment, and Hanan Huayer from the Dubai Design District, and Hussam Sayed from Esri, who will now walk you through not one, but several examples of how data visualization supported by Esri through the Dubai Pulse platform is already reshaping how we live, plan, manage our smart city.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Aisha. Well, we would like to show you four examples of how we're using distributed GIS to enhance safety, mobility, and efficiency, and connect with our citizens as we work to make Dubai the smartest and happiest city on Earth. There's always a lot going on in Dubai, where the population has tripled in the past 25 years. The Dubai Pulse platform allows us and the public to manage that growth by taking the pulse of the city in real time. It's the digital backbone of Dubai, with the ArcGIS platform serving as its spatial core. Dubai Pulse allows everybody to learn more about places, events, and projects in real time. Anyone can take the pulse of all the mega projects currently under construction, already completed, or in design. The Dubai Design District, or D3, is a new real estate development near downtown Dubai. It's home to many creative organizations involved in fashion, art, and culture. We can see details of the project, such as its status, its budget, and its estimated completion time. This app also provides a communication channel between the government and developers and the general public. We enable smart governance by taking the pulse of our connected citizens. In real time, we can see what people are saying, or what they're tweeting, or what they're posting on Facebook about the D3 project. Now, happiness is a critical component of assessing our residents' needs, and feedback like this helps us measure that. But we also need to consider other types of data. Another Pulse app helps us create smart mobility by using big data analytics to support evidence-based decision-making at the city level. Analyzing anonymized mobile phone data helps us understand home and work commute patterns and identify opportunities to improve our citizens' lives. Dubai is a linear city hugging almost 70 kilometers of the Gulf Coast, and a significant number of commuters travel the entire length of the emirate daily, from Deira in the north, all the way down to Jebel Ali, the fast-growing industrial and logistics hub in South Dubai. This long commute can take over an hour and leads to more traffic and road safety issues, which of course detract from our citizens' quality of life. So using data from Dubai Police, we've identified a high number of accidents occurring in Deira, where many commuters live, and along Sheikh Zayed Road, where many workers drive between Deira and Jebel Ali. Now, addressing road safety is clearly one of the key initiatives in our Smart Dubai strategy. But another key initiative in the Smart Dubai strategy is providing a smart environment. And for that, Hossam will show us how we're helping residents cut energy costs by generating their own electricity. Hossam?
Thank you. Thank you, Kaveh. The city leadership has set a target of producing 75% of energy from renewable sources by the year 2050. And DEWA, the Dubai Electricity and Water Authority, has launched the Shams Dubai Calculator app. This app estimates the potential of electricity generation for residents and business owners. Once the user logs in, the app locates their property and calculate the orientation and number of solar panels that can be installed. It also calculates the electricity production and carbon footprint per year. And more people use this app, DEWA is confident that Dubai can reach its energy goals by the year 2050. And one thing I learned from living in Dubai for a long time is that smart environment really requires smart infrastructure. And to show you an example of what I mean, please welcome Hanan, who will talk to us about the Dubai Design District. Hanan?
Thank you, Hossam. Our country is less than 50 years old, and we're very fortunate to have a modern economy, infrastructure, and ideas. One of those ideas is creating smart buildings and smart infrastructure. D3 is a testbed to many of Dubai Smart City initiatives, including the implementation of an IoT-enabled command and control center, where we monitor, analyze, and manage the building within the district. The district's operation dashboard is actually connected in real time to multiple systems, creating a strong decision support application. Ensuring our facilities run well is one of the key aspects of our business. Work orders come from our facility management system, and our facilities team can run the district more efficiently by visualizing all open and in progress, repair and maintenance requests, and responding quickly to them. That keeps our tenants happy by ensuring that we meet the service level they pay for. Our control center is also connected to our property management system, where we manage customer information. We can drill down up to a building view and see how much space is leased out per floor. The ability to understand where we have unoccupied space also allows us or helps us to match the right space to potential tenants. Energy conservation is also one of the biggest goals of Smart Dubai. IoT sensors from each tenant's space is connected to the application through the building management system. This lets us see the total energy usage per building, per floor, and up to the unit level. Analyzing the energy usage trends also helps our tenants reduce their business operating expenses and makes D3 a more attractive place to do business. This new command and control center really contributes to the success of D3 and Smart Dubai. With innovation that is driven by the integration of IoT and GIS, we have many new exciting development plans as we build out the district in the future. Thank you.
Thank you, Kaveh. Thank you. Thank you, Kaveh, Hanan, and Hossam. It's truly inspiring to see how such technologies and the progress in these implementation in our city has already made towards our vision. And the next 5 years will be a period of profound transformation for Dubai. In just 3 years, we will stand to gain $1.5 billion in value saved from blockchain. Yes, we are implementing blockchain as our transactions platform in the city. And we will be hosting Expo 2020 for 6 months. And we will have launched the first mission to Mars from the Arab world. And the year after that, we will be celebrating the United Arab Emirates' 50th National Day. And the last PayPal transaction by the Dubai government. And the realization of $2.9 billion added to the economy from Dubai data. But in many ways, this will only be the beginning. In the coming decades, we will witness 25% of our buildings being 3D printed. We have already a full-fledged building printed by 3D. And by 2030, one quarter of all trips on Dubai's road will use autonomous vehicles. And we just launched our drone taxi in Dubai. And in 2050, we will export our last drop of oil. And we are ready for all these activities, very busy activities in my city. In 2071, and I hope the smart technologies will take me to be live for that moment, where we will celebrate the centennial of the United Arab Emirates and mark our emergence as one of the best cities globally. And this is all in the lead up to 2117. Yes, we started all the plans and the projects, and it is up and running for 2117, when we will establish the first colony from the United Arab Emirates on Mars. And for every milestone in this remarkable future, Smart Dubai is today laying down the foundation. And why we are doing this? To make our people more happier. Because we are making Dubai the happiest city on Earth. Thank you.
Thank you. Wonderful. Thank you, Your Highness.
Thank you, Jack.
My great pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you, Jack, for this opportunity.
This is a woman with vision, wouldn't you agree?
Okay.
I mean, really? It's amazing.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Appreciate it.
And while she wouldn't say it so formally, she said it to me personally that one of the basic reasons why Dubai believes in doing this work, pushing the envelope, is to also be an example for the rest of us. This just grabbed my heart right away. It wasn't enough just to be the best or drive it, but to share it. That's why she came here. So ladies and gentlemen,
thank you, Dr. Esri. I just want to say one thing, Jack. Yes, one of our objectives is to share our knowledge for everyone. That's why we are working very closely with many international organizations, such as United Nations, but also ISO, or a standard organization. And we are building with them smart city maturity model to export our experience so that other cities can learn and can implement their digital transformation agenda. So please, for all these city mayors and city managers, please join us in this effort to develop this maturity model to more implemented platform.
Thank you for that invitation, collaboration.
Thank you,
Your Highness. Thank you very much. Amazing. Thank you, guys. Cities are complex, wouldn't you agree? Human settlements are complex. The attempt to be able to design cities, any city planner knows, they can only begin to approach the kind of complexity that cities have. They're a whole ecology in and of themselves.